What's going on, everyone? I've been testing a bunch of different telephoto lenses from cheap to very expensive, and I'm gonna help you decide which one is right for you. But first, cue the intro. The last 2 months of quarantine, I've been working on a rooftop quarantine photo series documenting the progression of rooftop culture from my roof in Brooklyn. Now, I've been experimenting with a bunch of different telephoto lenses, some very cheap, like the 75-300, which goes for $179 from Canon, and some are very, very expensive, like the Canon 100-400mm Mark II lens, which goes for $2,200, which is probably worth more than my soul would go for on the black market. My goal is that by the end of this video, you'll feel incredibly well-informed and ready to choose the perfect telephoto lens for you. So let's go through each of these lenses from cheapest to most expensive and talk about their strengths and weaknesses. Also, big thanks to Adorama for loaning me all this gear. There'll be links in the description to all of the lenses that I talk about in this video. Starting off with the cheapest lens, we have the Canon 75-300mm f4-5.6 lens. Now, this lens goes for $179, and as far as lenses go, that is an incredible deal. Now, it has all of the trappings you'd expect from a cheap lens. The focusing is a little bit slow, the zoom is a little bit choppy, the build is plasticky and cheap, it's not weather sealed, and the images are a little bit soft in comparison to a nicer lens. Like most cheap lenses, you're gonna be dealing with some heavier chromatic aberration and vignetting, and there is no internal stabilization. But in exchange for all these shortcomings, it is a very light lens, and it works with full frame cameras. So to put this weight into perspective, this lens weighs about 480 grams, which is almost 4 times lighter than this beast of a lens right here, the 100-400, which we'll be talking about in a second. In my opinion, this is a phenomenal beginner lens. Obviously, it doesn't stack up to the nicer, more expensive lenses that I'll be comparing it to today, but it gives you a lot of bang for your buck. And my advice to everyone is just to buy the lens that you can afford. So if this is gonna be your first telephoto lens, it's a really great starting off point. And it's incredibly light. If you're looking for professional quality optics, but you're on a serious budget, I wanna give an honorable mention to the Canon 70-200mm f4 lens. It's a bigger lens, but it's got top tier professional performance, very sharp image, super solid option, and it's relatively affordable. I know $600 is not cheap, but in relativity to the arm and a leg that the rest of the lenses I'm gonna talk about today will cost you, it's a pretty solid deal. Next off, I have a niche but powerful telephoto lens that I am a big fan of. This is the Canon 200mm f2.8 lens. It is an L series lens, so it is very high quality glass, it's weather sealed, it's got super quiet focusing, and it's quick. Now, the best part about this lens, shooting at f2.8, it means I can use this at night with no issues. All the other telephoto lenses I talk about today have a maximum aperture at f4 or f4.5, meaning they're phenomenal for daytime shooting, but when it comes to low light situations, nighttime, indoor stuff, they're pretty much useless. They get a lot harder to use, and for any action stuff with a faster shutter speed, you become very limited. Meanwhile, f2.8 is incredibly fast for a telephoto, which gives you tons of flexibility for low light shooting with faster shutter speeds. Beyond the professional quality optics, what cinched the deal for me on this lens is how light it is. So it weighs 765 grams, whereas a 70-200mm f2.8 is twice that weight. So because I do a ton of hiking and skating around, and I travel around with my gear quite a bit without a car, this lens keeps my camera bag light, yet still gives me a phenomenal telephoto option. This lens's lightness and affordability come at the expense of its versatility. People love prime lenses, especially wider primes like 35mm and 50mm, because there's a lot you can shoot at those focal lengths. Meanwhile, 200mm is relatively niche, and the odds of your subject always being that perfect distance away is relatively slim. So there will be times when you miss shots and you wish that you had some zoom range. And this is why people prefer telephoto zooms. But if lightness, affordability, and most importantly, a fast aperture are your priorities, then this lens is a winner. And I'm a huge fan of it. And this takes us to the big daddy lens, the Canon 100 to 400 millimeter f4.5 to 5.6 Mark II lens. This goes for $2,200 new, and it is a monstrous lens. It's also been my go-to lens. And let's just bang out the weaknesses so we can get into the strengths, because it has quite a few. So this lens obviously is absolutely massive and very heavy. And if you're into building your muscles, then that's a total perk. But for most people, that's a bummer, and it would suck to have to carry this lens in your camera bag all the time. At f4.5 to 5.6, it's not an incredibly fast lens. So in the middle of the day, no problem, powerful lens. But when you're shooting action shots with faster shutter speeds, you will be a little bit limited when you're shooting indoors or in lower light situations. But beyond those two attributes, this is a phenomenal lens. The build is excellent. It's got image stabilization, which lets me shoot at 400 millimeters handheld without worrying too much. It's got just a sturdy, sturdy build. It's weather sealed. It's got this zoom touch adjustment ring, which lets me decide how smooth or tight I want the zoom of this lens to be. So right now it's very smooth. This is great for getting you that perfect amount of friction you want when you're shooting with a zoom lens. It's got this geniusly designed retractable window on its lens hood, which lets you spin around filters with a finger without having to take the lens hood off. The autofocus is incredibly quick and the images are incredibly sharp. The optics on this lens are truly top tier. And lastly, we have this nifty tool, the Canon 2x Extender Mark III, also known as a teleconverter. And for $429, this will double the focal length of your lens. And it's a really powerful option. So my 100 to 400 becomes a 200 to 800. My 200 millimeter becomes a 400. You get the point. Now this does come with some trade-offs. First of all, you lose two stops of aperture. So a lens that shoots at f5.6 now shoots at f11, lowest possible aperture. An f2.8 lens is now shooting at f5.6. When your newly converted aperture is f8 or higher, you actually lose the ability to autofocus. So you either have to use manual focus or use live view. And this is what I have to do when I'm using the 100 to 400 millimeter. Bit of a pain, but not a deal breaker. Your focus speeds are gonna slow down about 75%, and it's gonna exacerbate all of your lens's flaws. So increase chromatic aberration, vignetting, and decrease sharpness and contrast. But all of these trade-offs are incredibly worthwhile when you consider the alternatives. So here's why people love extenders. One, affordability. Even though $429 is not cheap, lenses get exorbitantly expensive when you increase the focal length beyond what we're already shooting at. So for example, the Canon 800 millimeter f5.6 retails for $13,000. Meanwhile, Sigma makes a 200 to 500 millimeter f2.8, which goes for, I believe, $25,000. That is more money than, I'm pretty sure you could solve world hunger for a couple of these lenses. It is just so absurd how expensive they are. Second, size and weight. Extenders aren't that heavy, not that big. You can shoot handheld with them along with a 100 to 400 millimeter telephoto, no problem. Meanwhile, need I say any more? So while extenders are gonna take a hit to your optics, unless you've got the budget of a rich man and the strength of a robot arm or a tripod, you're probably not gonna wanna buy the lens alternative. Being able to shoot at 800 millimeters handheld is incredible. I have a few friends that live in my neighborhood, and I've been warning them, do not pick your nose when I'm up on the roof, because at 800 millimeters, I will see you and I will photograph you. Note that this extender is only compatible with some lenses, mostly telephoto lenses, so double check before you buy. Extenders make a lot of sense when you're shooting at super telephoto lengths where the lenses become astronomically more expensive. So a 400 millimeter lens with a 2x extender makes a lot more sense in many cases than an 800 millimeter lens. Meanwhile, the shorter focal length lenses, like a 100 millimeter lens with an extender, does not make much sense when you can just buy a 200 millimeter for a similar price. And you're gonna get much better optics if you can avoid using an extender. The flow is yours, the time is ours. Hey, believe me, you know. Rounding out this video with some lens buying advice, the best piece of advice I'll ever give you, again, is to only buy the lenses that you can afford. If it's out of your price range, scratch it off the list, don't even think about it. You'll make whatever you can afford work for you. If you do have a larger budget, then you have to start thinking about what attributes are most important to you. Is it having a fast aperture, a large zoom range, lightness, sharpness, etc.? Or maybe you just want the biggest, most impressive looking lens that makes people think you know what you're doing. There's no judgment here. I'd be lying if I said I didn't feel cool shooting with a 100 to 400. Once you've sorted out your priorities, then you want to think about your hard constraints. At what point is a lens too heavy, too slow an aperture, and too expensive for you? And once you've gotten all of these things sorted out, you're probably gonna be narrowed down to a couple different lenses, and then you can just start to do some Googling to figure out which one's best. My last piece of buying advice for any sort of camera gear is don't be swayed by beautiful test images. Even though I filled this video with lots of shots that I've taken, that was just for the sake of nice visuals. The fact of the matter is they subconsciously push you to think that a lens is good, when in actuality it's more about the photographer than it is the camera gear. And the right photographer can know how to make any lens work for them. I hope you guys found this helpful. Links to all the camera gear I mentioned in the description below. Subscribe for weekly videos. Check out my Instagram for more photos, and I will see you eventually.